What's happening, YouTube family? Farley here, and tonight I just want to do a real quick music collection update. It's going to be two albums, a CD, and I got a package from none other than Julian Lopez. I think I know what it is, but I have not opened it yet. So I wanted to share that experience with you guys and gals. So let's do it. First off, with a CD, something I've been after for a while on vinyl, and just gave up, went ahead, got the CD. This is Control Denied. A little bit of a super group involving Chuck Schuldiner of Death, before his death from brain cancer. It's a little bit different sound than Death. And it's an album I've listened to a lot streaming, but I've never owned a physical copy of it. I still will probably pick up the vinyl one of these days, but I got this at a really good deal, and so I couldn't pass it up. This is the two-disc set from, who put this up? Relapse. So on disc one, it's The Fragile Art of Existence, the CD, and then disc two is just basically the same songs that are on disc one, but some are like demo versions and, well, never mind, they're all demos. So, yeah, and then there's The Tune of Evil, which I'm not familiar with, but it's a Chuck Schuldiner comedy demo, so I look forward to hearing that. I have not broken the plastic on this yet, but I'm going to right now. And I'm pretty much late to the party. I've been wanting it forever. I started seeing a bunch of people start getting it, and I was like, man, I've got to get that. So I've been looking for it on vinyl, and, you know, it's not crazy priced, but lately I've been kind of having to budget between vinyl and comics. Yeah. And so I got this CD, really great price. So, you know, I said, you know what? That way I don't have to feel pressured to pay a lot for the vinyl, and I can kind of wait for the right deal to come along. The CD does not want to come out, though. Good night. This thing is packed in tight. Oh, well, instead of having you watch me fiddle around, well, here we go. Let's see if this will work. Goodness. They do not want you getting the CD out of this thing. Yeah, so anyway, I'll work on that later. But Control Denied. Am I upside down? Yep. Control Denied. Fragile Existence. With some bonus tracks. I don't know what year this CD came out, but if I could get the actual CD that's inside the slipcase out, I could maybe find out. But I'm not going forward anymore. I'll get that later. All right, so stoked to have that. And I will. This is a grail. I've always wanted the Pee-wee's Big Adventure soundtrack. Not originally. Every time it's been pressed, there's not enough music, I guess, to fill up two sides of an LP. So they always package it with Back to School. So this is the split Pee-wee's Big Adventure Back to School soundtrack, 12-inch. So both of these are Danny Elfman soundtracks. Side one, of course, is Pee-wee's Big Adventure. And then side two is Back to School. One of the just my favorite movies since I was a kid. This was the Barnes & Noble exclusive edition. I was not aware of it till like 2 weeks ago, and I was like, all right, it's a little bit more than I usually budget for vinyl, but I had to have it. So this is one of the reasons why I don't have a lot of records, because I spent a lot on just one. And it's on red vinyl, 180 gram. Sounds absolutely fantastic. I actually did a rip, but the YouTube gods said no, and so it was blocked. But this is on, I don't know this record label, so those of you who do will probably laugh at me, but that's all right, I'm used to that life. Varese Sarabande, or Sarabond, or something along those lines. But yeah, really, really cool. Glad to have this. And the last vinyl I've picked up myself is a reissue from 2013 of the Pogues breakthrough debut, Red Roses For Me. My copy had some background noise. It's another one I can't upload because of copyright. Yeah, just a reissue of their 1983 debut album, and it's on 180 gram black vinyl. Nothing fancy. Sounds good. Sounds good. Sounds a lot better than my OG pressing. I would still, if I saw an OG pressing for under $20, I would probably buy it if it was in near mint. Just because I want, it's one of those records that I don't have to have OG pressings. I like to sometimes on certain pressings, and that's one of them. It's just a quirk I have. There's certain albums that I want the OG on, some of my favorite albums. But I also want it to sound good. And like I say, my OG pressing of Red Roses For Me, it's a lot of background noise, especially on the run-in track and the outro. So run-in, run-out, static, and then in between songs, pretty bad. So it will be framed, and then I'll pick up another OG copy. Like I say, when I see one at a price and condition that I want. All right. Oh, before I get started, this is from my awesome buddy, Julian Lopez, who hit me up the other day on messaging and wanted to know if I had a certain album. I told him I did not. So he told me, you know, good, because I'm going to pick it up. And so I think that's what is in here. But we shall see. I have a package going out. Going out to Julian Lopez tomorrow. And if you're watching Andy Borders, I don't know if you're how you're doing. By the way, if you're friends with Andy Borders over at what was used to be known as Andy's Vinyl Den, he just had two back surgeries. So let him know you're thinking about him or something. Good dude. He's a good friend to most everybody in the VC and some other communities too, including comic books. So, like I say, if you, you know, if you think about it, send him some love. He's always been a really good friend to me, so. So, Andy, if you're watching this, I got a package going out to you tomorrow, too. I was waiting for you to get home, and then I think you went home, what's today? Tuesday? Did you go home Monday? So, all right. So, it is what I think it is. And there's a note. Make sure I don't. Oh, there's something else. He always has to throw in an extra, but that's all right because I'm throwing in extras for you. All right, so this. All right. So it's a very kind note, and I don't mind sharing it with everybody. From Julian, what's up, Roses? I'm very sorry about your loss. For those that don't know, lost my mom, and very unexpectedly, and so something I've been going through over the past week and 4 days now, and so I've had a lot of people check on me, and Julian is one of them, and so I've had a lot of people that are friends with me on Facebook because there was the obituary, and so they knew what it was. I haven't said a lot on YouTube. Some people have reached out. Yeah, so lost my dad 2011 and lost my mom a week and 4 days ago. So been going through that and still going through it. And I want to thank everybody that's reached out to me. So it means a lot. Julian, thank you. He says, I know things can't be healed overnight, but I hope these albums will serve some purpose with what you're going through. Thank you, man. Music is my catharsis and my friends. This is also my way of saying thank you for getting me into the Crucified. I had sent him a Crucified album before. The CD I sent is by a psychedelic stoner rock band that I really dig. Tight rhythm section, love the bass lines. Take care, brother Julian. Julian is just another one of those cool dudes that I've met, you know, in this case, the vinyl community, but he does CDs. So I just say the music community that you just know that if you were around them, you would be hanging out, going to shows and having a good time. Unfortunately, he's on one coast and I'm on the other, but distance sucks. So this is the CD he sent me. This is the, looks like the Entrance Band. I am not familiar with them at all. It's from 2009. I guess it's self-titled. Oh, no, or maybe that's the record label. Ecstatic Peace, I think it's the record label. Universal Motown. So I think it's just the Entrance Band self-titled. So I will be checking them out. In here. So really cool packaging, man. So thank you for sending me this, man. He sent me so many bands. We kind of do it back and forth to each other. He's got me into Castle and what's the other band you sent me last time? I can't think of the name of the band, but he's got me into some bands. I've got him in some bands, and then our tastes are crazy similar. So, but the difference, he's a lot younger than I am, and so for him to be into a lot of the music I'm into is cool. It just shows you that metal and really good music, man, doesn't really have like an age group. You know what I mean? So, and then he sent me this album, which I did not have, by a band called The Crucified. This is a band I got into 91, maybe 90, 91. They've got a hardcore sound, similar to a lot of the New York style hardcore. But they are a Christian influenced band. But let me tell you something. I would put their musicianship up against anybody, man. They are just a very, very tight band. Some people are not into the vocals. I am. I'm a huge fan of everything Crucified. This is a album that I want to say I had on cassette, but no longer do. And, look at these labels. Oh, wow. I've never seen this color. Two shades of green. Look at that. Almost like a military style. So you've got one side, Tooth and Nail, a very, very well-known Christian label. And... so, I don't own a lot of Christian music, but I had a phase where it was really all I listened to from in maybe like 93 to 94. And so, it was a lot of Vengeance Rising and The Crucified. There was some more Mortification, a lot of the heavier style, metal and death metal and all that, what they call, what is it, white metal. But, Julian, thanks a lot for the kind words, for the tunes, man. You know I dig you. You know I love you like a brother, and I appreciate you sending me this stuff. The note really meant a lot. The message you sent me on Messenger, I want to let you know I really, really appreciated that, too. Again, anybody that's reached out, whether you kind of knew what was going on or you kind of thought something might be going on, now you know. Everybody goes through this, I understand, and so I'm going to get through it, and having some new tunes really means a lot, because there's a lot of times where I just want to tune out the world and turn up the music, you know, so I want to thank everybody, man. I love y'all. Love all the communities, man, so I appreciate everybody. Like I say, some of you reached out, didn't know what was going on, but you're like, you know what, something's different, so I appreciate that too, man. It means a lot, so I just want to let you know you're appreciated, even though I can't tell you in person. The communities mean a lot to me. So, all right, I'm going to quit blabbing. Thanks, Julian. Thanks, everybody else, for watching. And I got some new tunes to check out. Might try to do a vinyl rip tonight. We'll see. But take care, everybody, and talk to you soon. Farley out.